Hello, and thank you for watching this instructional video on how to securely submit a grant application for the Texas Emissions Reduction Plan, a program of the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality. You may not realize this. The emails you are sending are, most likely, not secure. This is why we recommend sending your grant application, which may contain sensitive information, to us using our FTPS service. You might be asking yourself, what is FTPS? Simply put, it is a way to securely transmit information over the internet. How do you use our FTPS service? We'll cover that now. But basically, you just need to first create an FTPS account and then share your files. And that's it. If all your files are ready to share, then this whole process should take you less than 5 minutes. Now let us go through these steps together. To create an account, pull up our website by typing ftps.tceq.texas.gov into your web browser and clicking Enter. Any web browser should work, such as Google Chrome and Microsoft Edge. After it opens, click on the link that says Accounts for Non-TCEQ Staff, and then go to the top of the screen where you'll see five buttons. Click on the button that says Sign Up a New Account. Next, enter your name and email address. Then click Submit. A pop-up will appear asking you to go and check your email. You should have received an email from ftp_account@tceq.texas.gov, which contains a link and instructions on creating a password for your new FTPS account. If you don't see the email, it's probably in your junk email folder. This is what the email should look like. Click on the link so you can set up your password for your FTPS account. After clicking the link, a window in your web browser will open and it will show this window that says Reset Your Password. You'll use it to create your first password for your new FTPS account. The password you enter must be 8 characters long and it must include a lowercase letter, a capital letter, and a number. Once you enter your password and then entered it again for confirmation, click the button Reset Password. There you go. You now have an FTPS account. If you're ready to submit your grant application, click on the OK button to go back to the main login screen. Now the next step, sharing files. Files like your application and any other documents that you have to submit along with your application. The first thing you need to do is to log in. In the field username, enter your email address. Then enter your password and click the login button. After you log in, this is the screen that you'll see. There are buttons at the top and bottom and 2 default folders, which you don't really need to use. Okay, so to share your files, you'll need to first upload them into FTPS. The easiest way to do this is the drag and drop option. You do this by placing all the files that you need onto your desktop. Then select them all and then drag into FTPS. Here's a quick video demonstrating how easy it is to do this. In this demo, I need to upload 6 files. I select, drag, drop, and they automatically upload. After the files have uploaded, you now need to share them. Do this by clicking the box on the left of each file. After they are all selected, click the Share button. The screen will pop up and ask you to enter an email address. The email address that you enter will depend on the grant program that you're applying for. Here is a list of the current email addresses. Most of them have the grant program acronyms in it, along with the word apply. For example, for the Light Duty Motor Vehicle Purchase or Lease Incentive Program, or Light Duty for short, you would enter ldplip-apply@tceq.texas.gov. After you enter it, click the Add button. You will know if you have entered it correctly if the email address appears on the screen under Selected Recipients. Next, click the OK button. This pop-up will appear on the screen to confirm the files you are sharing along with the email address you're sharing it with. If everything is correct, click the OK button. And success! You have shared files. The next thing to do is to send an email to notify us that you have shared files. This is easy. All you need to do is click the OK button on the pop-up screen labeled Notify Recipients. You do have the option to update the email language, but it is not necessary. And now you're done. You can go ahead and log out of your FTPS account. But before we finish, here are some quick tips that will help to ensure that your application is correctly processed. Tip number one, file names should match the file's contents. For example, if you have a file that is a W-9 form, then the file name should be W-9. Tip number two, you should keep the files you are sharing unlocked. Typically, files are locked to keep the information within them secure. But since you're using FTPS and transmitting the information securely, there isn't much of a need to lock your files. Tip number three, upload all files for your application at the same time. For security reasons, files that are uploaded into FTPS are automatically deleted in 7 days. So uploading at the same time ensures that you don't have to worry about this automated deletion. And tip number four, share all files for your application at the same time. Getting everything for your application at the same time ensures that the fastest processing time for your application. Tip number five, if you need to revise one of your files, include the word revised in your file name and then share it. For example, if you sent us a W-9 form and you now need to revise it, then make the revision and then revise it with the word revised at the beginning of the file name. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions specifically about FTPS, such as any questions about your account or any questions about the features within FTPS, please go online and go to the webpage ftps.tceq.texas.gov/help. For any questions about TERP, you can call us at 800-919-TERP or by email terp@tceq.texas.gov.